Well, and more than 75,000 Kaiser Permanente workers have walked out for a three-day strike against the health care provider. It could stall services for nearly 13 million people in the United States. Health care workers are on strike to demand better, safer care for their patients and living wages for frontline workers. Let's bring in Service Employees International Union International President Mary Kay Henry for some perspective. Mary Kay, thanks very much for your time. Maybe you can outline for us what has been the key concern from your vantage point?
Well, Kaiser Permanente healthcare workers are burnt out and fed up, and they want Kaiser to address the staffing crisis and ensure that they can deliver safe patient care to every Kaiser member and have living wages for frontline workers that carried us through the pandemic. And I think you know Kaiser made $3 billion in profits just in the first half of 2023. So we are fully backing the demands of the 75,000 healthcare workers that are on strike.
Mary Kay, there's, I think, two very important differences between this strike and that of the UAW. Not that cars aren't important, but these workers are truly essential. The workers you represent really are at hospitals, at nursing homes, also teachers in public schools and universities, cops, for example. So we need these kinds of workers. And then in terms of the Kaiser Permanente strike specifically, it's not just about the workers and what they want. They're also worried about their patients. Tell us about that separate part of it. What's the concern about patient care that SEIU workers don't think is good enough?
Well, if there aren't enough staff in the OR, for example, patients who finish their surgery can't be transported into the recovery room quickly enough for the surgical room to be cleaned and sterilized for the next patient. And so everything backs up. And that's just one example of thousands of examples I could give you of when short staffing impacts patient care. And that's why workers who've been bargaining for months and didn't want to go on strike finally felt like they had to take strike action in order to get Kaiser to bargain in good faith to address the staffing crisis and to raise frontline wages.
Are you having, are you hearing concerns also from patients themselves? I mean, it strikes me that in that kind of scenario, Kaiser Permanente, if they're your insurer, they're responsible for making sure there is enough staff. And if you get, you know, an infection because they have understaffed ORs, I would guess they're liable to be sued.
Yeah, many Kaiser patients stand in solidarity with the demands that the workers are making because they've experienced over the past 3 years since we came out of the global health pandemic and people have returned to regular preventative care. They've experienced the staffing shortage by longer wait times on the phone or longer wait times in clinics or the inability to get from the ER to the floor of the hospital. And so there's multiple impacts of the staffing shortage that Kaiser patients experience. And you're right. That's what makes a healthcare worker strike unique. Workers are striking on their own behalf, but also because they care deeply about the mission of their employer, which is to provide quality, safe health care for everyone.
Bloomberg Law has estimated this Kaiser strike would be the largest for the U.S. healthcare industry by at least 20,000 workers. And since we have highlighted some of the other labor disruptions we have seen across the United States, Mary Kay, what can you tell us about the length of time? We talked about the initial time frame here, but at a time when there's worries about the overall economy and disruptions to workforces, what kind of time frame should we be thinking about longer term here?
Well, the workers serve the required 10-day notice for a three-day unfair labor practice strike, and that concludes tomorrow. And bargaining was going on yesterday during the first day of the strike. I think it has not happening today, and we'll see if tomorrow the employer returns to the table and is able to settle this dispute. If it doesn't get settled, The workers will vote again to authorize their bargaining committee to call additional strikes.
What are the workers actually asking for? We know in the case of the UAW, they want at least a 30% pay rise. They want defined pension benefits, defined benefit pensions, and they want, I believe they still are pushing for a four-day work week. What about these Kaiser Permanente workers? What are they asking for?
Well, you know, the wage demand was made early in the bargaining, and my recollection is that the initial demand was 7% annually for the 4 years of the contract. But I think the bargaining committee is in discussion about that demand now.
Before I let you go, Mary Kay, just for obviously you've highlighted some of the stress that workers have felt and the requests they have. How should those who are watching this as patients who maybe have non-essential services and they're seeing some of these headlines, how should they navigate through all this as well?
Well, you know, the union has set up a phone center to help people navigate. What we ask for is patient support for the workers' demands, because we want them to stand in solidarity with us to address the staffing crisis and make sure we're adequately staffed to provide the care that we believe they deserve and that they've been demanding. And so I think patience is the most important thing for Kaiser members that are watching now, and to stay connected to the news about what workers are able to achieve.
Mary Kay, great talking to you. Thanks so much for joining us. SEIU International President Mary Kay Henry talking to us about workers striking Kaiser Permanente.